So I'm in a little bit of a predicament here, actually, because apparently when I was doing filming all the scenes, editing, such 4K, and this device's internal storage is only 16. So then when I went to look and I saw 10 gigabytes, I'm wondering, okay, why is that so? And then I looked into the video's properties, and go figure, it was such a 4K, and I didn't even realize that. And because the way a lot of these phones are designed these days, they like make the card slot and the SIM tray. They make it simply that. They make it like as a tray rather than just easily making the phone's back movable so you can just easily access it. So what I was trying to do is trying to find something I could use to just open it up because it may not work. I tried actually using a pine needle and I couldn't get into it. Tried using some screw off the ground, and I don't recommend doing that because you can get tetanus, but I was careful obviously, of course. And that still didn't open up. Like, how do you get into a SIM tray to access, the SIM tray itself? It shouldn't be so difficult like that. Like, why do they have to make these phones so inaccessible these days with non-removable batteries and trays rather than just making a removable back where you can just access everything? The battery, the SIM card, and your card slot. But no, it's all about looks. Now, of course, I obviously didn't have to buy this phone. I could have went for the 950 XL, but I didn't. So, I guess that's kind of the price I'm paying for using the 1520 or the 950 XL. Well, actually, I could have just been prepared. I should have obviously just bought a SIM card remover. I should have bought this though. But I didn't do that, so I guess the lesson here is that if you're going to buy a phone like that, you always make sure you buy appropriate tools and make sure you're actually able to get into the thing, and that's a nice idea as well. More navigators. So yeah, it looks like they're building something up there, I don't know what exactly, but it looks like at some point during this Northwest Whitney adventure, I'm going to have to resort to using a BlackBerry Q10, even though I really don't want to because that camera shakes like a crazy freak if I had 10 cups of coffee in the morning. So I really hate to resort to using that, but it looks like it's gonna have to happen because it's just how much storage in this thing. I just can't get the darn cards out of the device because look how they make these phones these days. Man, do I miss the days where you can just easily peel off the back, access your battery, access your SIM tray, and access your card slot. Like, why can't they just go back to it? It's really that hard to just make a phone like that. Come on. Okay, that giant thing I believe is some type of dome. I don't know what it is. I don't know, or some sports center. I don't think it's a dome. Maybe it is, maybe it isn't. I don't know what it is. I'm just kind of mad about the whole card slot thing. And then another thing I'm kind of mad about is the fact that 4K video, when you open, say, you need to open up some app in the store today. And I'm like, what? Okay, so first, it's already annoying me by not letting me access the card slot. You know, I have to download some app just to see my 4K video. What kind of nonsense is that? The other day, I did a 4K video and it didn't tell me that I had to do that. So why is it telling me that now? But I'll look into that when I get home and see why they're telling me to download another app just to watch my own 4K video. Well, as long as I get to watch it some way or another, I'll be fine. But if I don't, then that's serious business. I heard a beep somewhere there, I don't know what that's for. I don't know how large this video is going to be, but hopefully it won't come up to like over a gigabyte. Probably will, but I'm hoping not. But I'll just use this thing as much as I can without having to use the Q-tip. But you don't want to have to use a Q-tip. Goodness gracious. Like, after using this thing, I don't want to ever go back to anything without OIS. I don't. Who would anyway? Like, once you use a phone for a long time and no OIS, and then when you finally use something that does have optical image stabilization, it's like, whoa, night and day difference. I can tell you that, night and day difference. Okay, so it's Donald A. Wilson. I think I said Donald J. Wilson. Looks like I got that wrong. It's not Donald A. Wilson. Donald J. Wilson. I don't know why I've been saying that. I really need to learn the names of some of these places I'm going to rather than just saying all sorts of nonsense. Like, I mean, I obviously know where it is, but it doesn't help that I didn't understand the name properly. So now that I have this fully done, I can go to this video.
Donald A. Wilsonites and others, did you like this video? Comment, rate, like, subscribe, share, read my blog for information, and visit my Twitter page to my latest tweets. And do not forget to also participate in the polls in the top right corner in the eye circle.